Hello and welcome back to Farming Simulator 2017 Gold Crest Valley Episode 2. In our last episode, we harvested a field and got this rather dismal pile of wheat. Not the biggest pile I've ever seen in the world, but it's only from field 15, so I can't complain too much. The task for today is I'd like to plough field 14, possibly cultivate it too, but we'll just start with ploughing and see how we get on. This tractor has slightly more power than the New Holland. Obviously it's identical to that other case over there, but this one has slightly more hours on it, so might as well put a few more on it. This painfully small plough. And make our way over to field 14. I do plan to bale field 15. I think about it, and I think baling is the way to go. It's slightly easier to stack, and I think it's the way to go on that one. I'm not entirely sure of the best way to have the plough turned, but we'll just go with that. It's doing the job anyway. I'm not sure if that's the correct way. It's working. Got my straightest line in the world here. Well, yeah, I do. Obviously my presets are set quite low, so the furrows are not accurate to the direction that I'm travelling. But that's not the end of the world. Get another frame rate drop there. I do enjoy a good frame rate drop. Keeps me interested. Who doesn't love to see their system struggle to run a game on the low settings? Hopefully we'll get through this field quite reasonably quick today. That is quite small, so that's what I'm doing. Obviously I have set to stay within the confines of the pre-designed field, so I would just turn less in very quickly. I have missed a small stretch of the field there. Hopefully it won't be much. This field is actually quite big. Hopefully as quickly as possible. Frame rate drop may be as a result of at the time that I'm recording this episode, I'm actually uploading the last episode to YouTube, which could possibly explain the slightly worse frame rates I'm getting today. But the last video actually turned out to be quite a lot longer than I had originally intended. I planned for a 25 to 30 minute video and it was almost 20 minutes. But not 20. Let me know how long the video, how long you would like the videos, and I will try and cater to that. I've also changed my time scale to times 50. As I mentioned in the last video, I just think it would be better to have the video end at the end of the day. I can skip through the night off camera. I gather that YouTube is not the biggest fan of visually dark videos. Obviously, Farmers in Winter 17 does like to get dark at night, unlike the previous Farmers in Winter. The nighttime was just slightly less bright than the middle of the day. In this game, obviously, it gets realistically dark for countryside. Which is understandable. A lot of back and forth involved in Tangler Fields. It's the other thing I like about having the less cookie cutter style field is you can just rotate around the field over and over again until the stand. Makes the job significantly quicker. Although technically possible, one hour kind of field seems unrealistic, but you'd in circles around the field. Obviously in reality you probably wouldn't plow the field rotationally, but the only thing about games is they allow you to do things that reality does not. Worried about missing little bits here and there, as almost the majority of the field was playing, I'll be quite satisfied with that. It's just somewhat of a laborious task. But it is actually one of my more preferred tasks to do. I'd find that drop at the bottom of this field. Mess that bit up over here. And I think I'm just making things worse for myself. Okay. This is the one of the Giants mods for ground response. As you can see, when I'm not driving through the furrows, it's quite smooth. If I move over slightly into the furrows, it becomes quite rough. It's a wonderful mod. Very well done. To be fair, give credit for that one. That one is very good. And the 2D textures that they The 2D textures that they use for the plowed ground texture also significantly better than previous versions of the game. Previous versions of the game felt very flat in my opinion. Not any less enjoyable of course, but could be better. Even this texture, very two dimensional, but gives the appearance of a three-dimensional texture, which I think is a good compromise. And hopefully farming simulator 19, I will have 3D textures. So something I'd certainly like to see. Way through the future, I am terrible at lining this back up. Just atrocious. This will be why I'm not really a farmer. Some jobs should be left to the professionals, and apparently reversing a plow is one of them. A professional? Certainly I'm not. I need to at some point see about getting some kind of fertilizer sprayer or sprayer. Manure spreader, something along those lines, to spray this field. I probably won't cultivate it today, because I have the three stages of spraying on, and my logic would be, what I personally like to do is, I spray once after plowing, once after cultivating, and once after seeding, and that gives the covers that it requires. I do have the horse gear hose, I believe that's how you pronounce it, mod installed. So I will hopefully be upgrading my cedar to one of them, so I don't still just have the standard cedar that is here and the remote demand, the default cedar if you will. Quite a small cedar, but I suppose that would go in with the rest of the equipment we have on it. And none of our equipment is yet particularly expensive or large. I believe these case tractors have 145 horsepower. So, not exactly earth-destroying power. Reasonable enough to get the job done, but it's actually the same horsepower that my 17-year-old car has. My doubts about my car's ability to drag what I'd imagine would be quite a heavy plow around the field. There could be some interesting furrows left in the field that wouldn't be from the plow. I would probably need a new car. If you can tell, I'm used to using a slightly bigger plow in this game. This plow is actually slightly narrower than the tractor. Possibly the same size. It's certainly not the most efficient in the world. Just on the mini-map, we are roughly halfway through this field. So it's slightly the most useless plan I've ever had. I have in fact used a couple of mods, specifically from my Farm Simulator 15, where Dragon's released the classic farming pack. That's was quite a interesting vehicles that came with that. It's the classic tractors and implements to go with them. Added a new aspect of challenge to the game. Even without any extra fuels, everything seemed slightly more stressful. With everything was so small to use. I personally found the big old loader from that pack was quite easy. They also could collect double bell and thrown into the cage. No stacking of any kind done there, just put in. I would actually like to see the DLC pack included in Final Fantasy Over 17 or even 19, so they did add that interesting aspect. Much cheaper equipment for the beginnings of the game at least. You can turn a quick profit and purchase a few extra fuels by selling your default equipment and replacing it with farming classics equipment. And then there was the easiest tractors to use, so from like trailer hitches, 3-point linkages and lights, but they were certainly fun tractors to drive on a bike anyway. Roughly halfway done if you ignore the slightly patchy finish that I've left. At least I'm plowing more than I'm missing, as it's hopefully this won't take too much longer. This video may be slightly shorter as it is a direct continuation from the previous video. So I'm still technically on in-game day 1. I've adjusted my time scale now so that I will end the video when it starts to get dark. So hopefully I will have this field completely plowed by then. The hope anyway. I'm just about that if that popped up in the recording. Computer's certainly not happy with something there and gave me a message. Not sure if that will display in the recording, but that would explain why there was a short delay in there. Maybe we do remember. I will deal with that issue at the end of this field. Nothing serious, I'd imagine, just possibly. Micro-rolled AMD processor to get too much out of this. So it's quite a reasonable processor for being a micro-rolled machine. Like I said in the previous video, it's running the recording software. Currently it's doing the recording of this video, running the game, as well as uploading a video onto YouTube, as well as have the performance manager looking to keep tabs on my CPU as always. So obviously not anything new, not the most stable of processors in the world. To give it a little bit of a tweak to actually prevent it overheating while playing 7 Days to Die, a game that I didn't think was particularly stressing on the CPU, but it appears course it, of course I disagree with that. I do also intend on recording other games as well. I plan on recording some Euro Truck Simulator 2, as well as 7 Days to Die, and I've had a conversation with a good friend of mine about doing a multiplayer series of modded Minecraft. I'm still awaiting some information back from the creator of the mod that we intend to use on that one. And obviously, I believe he will be uploading and recording and uploading his screen to YouTube as well, so I need to find out how he's getting on with setting up his channel as well as his recording software. He has a very powerful system, so he will probably run the multiplayer server from his end. It's quite a pretty expensive setup he has. He in fact gave me the majority of my gaming rig just as a present, which was quite nice of him. Obviously replaced his setup, so he gave me his open, which I'm very thankful for. He even supplied me with a reasonable graphics card. Nothing overly modern or fancy, but it did work, and I did use it for a little while. To NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1080 Ti, and I'm considering actually further upgrading to a Titan XP, which I think would be quite lovely to be able to run some brand new games on high-end graphics settings. If they will remove all of this frame rate issues I'm having in my laptop, but considering that the laptop I'm using has been extensively used over a number of years, in both a gaming capacity and as in a professional capacity, and it's it is a reasonable bit of kit. It's, it does handle what I ask it to do without catching fire at least, so that is always a bonus. At least it doesn't overheat anymore. My plans for the channel are to have 3 or 4 current series running for, I personally prefer to do a minimum of 30 episodes per series, or 30 parts per series. But what I'd rather do is have the, like I'm doing with this series, it's an open-ended series to the point where I'll close this series when we've reached the infamous 1.1 million, which currently seems a long way off. But we'll have to start somewhere. Once I have my fields prepared and I may do it, I may start it on this episode. What I'd like to do is do at least one contract job per episode going forward, so that you're not just seeing me tediously drive back and forth up and down the field. You're also getting some better content, with some different machines and different fields as well, and of course it also brings in a little bit of extra money. At this stage, obviously the majority of the contract point will be the likes of Square, possibly Fang, hopefully not. I think if a job I go to for this episode involves planning, I think I will go to a different field. I'll try and keep the jobs different to what I've been doing on my own fields, for obvious reasons. Too much of a good thing isn't good for anyone. I think what I'll do is I'll just get this field ploughed for today. I may plough a field 12 off camera, or I may leave field 12 for this rotation of crops. I do currently have 3 fields. If I periodic ploughing would mean that I'd have to plough the fields every 3 crops, or 3 years if you will. I think what I would do is do a different field every year, so that I'm not just firing continuously. So I'll do this field for this crop cycle, and I'll go ahead and cultivate fields 12 and 15 ready for sheeting, obviously after I pick up the straw. That'll be baling it. I'm not entirely sure how I can afford that just now, so I don't have a bit of it. I'll require about releasing 1 bank. I have the funds to do that. Obviously, I don't need it for the day. I may purchase a lawnmower. And while I'm in possession of baler, I may do some grass bales as well. As well as doing some bales for silage. We can get some reasonable money from silage bales. But we will see what happens with that. That may be the next episode where I'll do a bit of lawn care. There is a small grass field in front of me there. I'm going to chop down the trees to make it slightly easier on me. And I won't do that just yet. I'll probably chop down the trees off camera. So go back over there, by mistake. I'm suffering quite badly with frame rate drops, so I don't think I'll record at the same time as uploading after this video. Is I have the mod for the transit van, so what I will do is, when I can afford to buy the transit van, I will do an episode or two of Forest Remake, where I'm building the shortened logs into the transit van, and obviously strapping them down. Hopefully my driving during that will be better than the last time I did that. I obviously did not record that, it was before I was recording anything for YouTube. But needless to say, it resulted in a vehicle being reset. That's where I found out that if you have legs in the back of your transit van and you reset your vehicle, it leaves the legs there. It's a lovely thing to find out at the time. But actually I managed to wedge the van between the 2 trees upside down. I was actually reasonably impressed with myself. I didn't think I would have been able to do that again if I tried. Obviously my driving and farming simulator is not the best. I believe my driving in real life is slightly better than that, although I do know a few people that would probably say contrary. But especially in the knob and lot of tractors, like the pickup and the transit van, they go higher speed than my I don't know, just atrocious. If there was a police aspect of this game, I would lose all my money and funds. And insurance claims. Although, to be perfectly honest, I don't think I'm looking better in the truck. I also would like to do a series of 70s Today, as that is actually one of my favourite games. I do enjoy playing 70s Today quite a lot. I won't be getting to that one just yet. I have a few other games that I'd like to do. But I'd like to focus on Farming Simulator. Farming Simulator was going to be one of the staples of my channel. I'd like to always have a Farming Simulator playlist. Amazing and a good game. It's always something to do. And in my opinion, it never gets old. I still find myself playing my Farming Simulator 2008 and 2009 on the odd occasion. So it's quite a long time ago. I remember when I first bought a Farming Simulator, I actually bought the DVD ROM of Farming Simulator 2008 from a supermarket that was local to me at the time. It came in a bundle with Bus Driving Simulator. And ever since then, I've been hooked. I've owned, and in fact still do own, every Farming Simulator that's been released. As well as a couple of other farming related games. Farming Simulator has been my constant. I've always gone back to Farming Simulator regardless of if I briefly play other games. I'm almost done here. Three or four more runs up and down this field, and then a lot of tidying up. And then we will go and take a contract job if there's enough time to do so. If not, I will start that in the next video. I did start to go a little bit later than I usually did, given that my last video is off, happened in the morning of this video. Do is I will turn the, I know there's a hotkey for this, I'll turn it down to times 5 for the time being so I can get rid of the drop in front. I'll turn it down to real time for now. Video will obviously start earlier than this one, and end around the same time, so this will give me my general idea of how long my videos will be naturally. I'm also new to video editing, so I'm aware there is a way to time-lapse things like this, which will probably be the way to go in the future. I just haven't figured out how to do that quite yet. But I'm sure I will figure it out soon enough. The whole concept of YouTube, recording videos, editing them, etc. is a brand new concept for me. I'm learning it as I go. It's not something I've ever done before. I've never even recorded game footage for myself before. I've watched YouTube avidly, but never contributed to it. Tripped up over my own tongue. So, hopefully I'm not doing anything wrong, but if I am, feel free to let me know. I previously mentioned, I haven't yet looked at the comments for part 1 yet, as I'm uploading it currently as I'm recording this one, and we're most likely to be recording part 3 at probably doing that today, I expect. I thought it would just be best to have a couple of recordings in advance, ready to upload. I'm experiencing the infamous length of time it takes to upload a video onto YouTube for myself. I've heard about it, but I've never uploaded anything to YouTube before, it means I've never experienced it. And the rumors are true. Part 1, clicked upload for part 1, it estimated 45 minutes to upload part 1, which is quite a long time. That was terrible. I missed that completely now. I could probably do this better just by going up and down the fuse. My intention is to upload a Farmers of Moonlight video at least every day. No less than one video a day from Farmers of Moonlight. I may upload more groups here and there. And if you did multiple series and things like that, obviously there'd be a more detailed schedule to inform everyone about. But currently, as it's just this one series that I've gotten around to record so far, there's the only schedule of a video every day. I may upload this part, and maybe even the next part of this series today, because currently there is nothing on my channel. This is my first series, with part 1 being my first ever episode. So hopefully it does well. Yeah, I'm gonna drop it for a minute. I don't mind tiny little bits like that bit over there that I've missed. That's fine. These longer strips I'd like to clear away and then feel it's seen unfinished and patching. With my lack of view distance. This is one of those jobs that if a hired worker had done it, it would have actually been worse. They are pretty reasonable with the AI vehicle mod. They tend to try and at least try a little field, but the default locals don't know where they learn to drive, but they tend to leave about as much of the field as they can. Not that I want to talk. Rest of this over here. I'm sure I could do this quicker if I left it by two. usually do a meter drill class. I'm not so used to having a slightly bigger crowd. Significantly more powerful dragon. I usually have a modded tractor. In fact, that I use as my go-to tractor. It's a class tractor. With 485 horsepower. Without the model itself being too ridiculously big. Which is it's quite nice. It's interactive controls. I can't remember off the top of my head who was that made it, but I'll be looking to get in touch with them to make sure that they're okay with me using it in my Let's Plays, and I will be including it in this series. It's one of my personal favourites. I'm also personally a fan of Fendt tractors. I like the old style boxy look of tractors, but this one sort of has. It's not a bad tractor, this one. Still a little bit smaller for being overly useful. But it can do for now. It's managing this plow pretty reasonably. I'll go with where this small, almost any tractor would manage this, I expect. Maybe not the ones from the aforementioned classics, but most modern tractors should manage this this plow. It's there we go. But neither is the fields I have, so I don't need any 6 meter plow or anything like that. I believe this plow is 2 or 3 meters off the top of my head. Like I said, it's a drop, so it reasonably serves a plow. Something I will be using sensibly anyway, so I'll just try and actually reverse it. That would be a pillar. Not something you really want to reverse into. I will leave it there and pretend that that is the intended place for it. Down to a field and do a job. Field 19, it's nice and close to the farm. Given that we are running low on light, it's not far away from the sun going down. I will just take the nearest field too. Not the ridiculous as well field either. Tractor out of the room, turn the lights off and turn the engine off, no point wasting fuel on it. 20 to 8 at night, and they want me to spray. We'll go for that. I think that's a Steyr multi-tractor, I think it is. A modern tractor. Push the dev is this square? Doesn't look too ridiculous. Nothing worse than having like a 40 meter square. And I'll turn it on. Let's go. Minutes and 50 seconds. It was pretty reasonable for a little field like this. I'll get it done as quickly as possible. It's not my fertilizer, so I'm not going to waste time turning it on and off while turning. Something like I would do if it was my own. Already done over a third of the field, so 3 minutes was certainly really generous. Didn't come down this field much straight away in the first place, which never helps. Going back away is going to be pretty fun. Seems like 4 passes would be adequate to do this field. But a little weird task in itself, this one, but a necessary one, I suppose. To get us a little bit more money. I didn't really care how much money this job is worth. Something I probably should have done. I wonder if I could finish the field with just... Oh, we've got 2 minutes. Timer's turned red. Time left. There we go. £2,000, that's or near as matters to £2,000, that's a good start. So we'll just jump back in our case here. This tractor. I'll put my headlights on for this. This tractor. Right. Turn it off. And I will end the episode here. So if you're enjoying the content, please don't forget to like and subscribe, and thank you for watching.